So you can imagine trying to recruit a sample of this size is also challenging. And at each of the site, we had strengths in clinical people who had a network of connections in their state. And so those relationships that come through the clinic are really valuable to a researcher because those clinicians can reach out to their contacts, make them aware of the study, and ask that individuals help us in the recruiting enterprise. We've had wonderful collaboration from various clinics and families. Families understand that there's not been a lot of research on hard of hearing children, their children. And in general, they've been quite invested in contributing. And professionals have understood that message also. But we've had amazing collaboration. For example, the University of Kansas allows us to come and work in their speech and hearing clinic to gather data from the Kansas area. The Moog School in St. Louis is collaborating in the same way. And what's in it for them? They're contributing to the science. Their families are allowed to participate in the research, but it's not that easy to open up your clinic, open up your doors to a research team coming in and gathering data. So we're very appreciative. We have another center in Wichita doing the same thing. So that's really promoted our project. And always in a longitudinal study, attrition is something you worry about. We've had very minimal attrition, I'm pleased to report. But part of that was also something we thought about a lot. Staying in contact with our families, as I mentioned, communicating well with referral sources. We would send newsletters periodically telling them what we were discovering and how much we valued their contribution. We did newsletters like that for the parents as well. In fact, one of them looks like a Time magazine, and we put their child's image on the front of this magazine. And all the parents were so proud to see that newsletter with their child's image. And what we did was a parent-friendly summary of some of our discoveries. And I can't say enough about that. Also, families that are seen by our team, they're able to share with their school district and their audiologist a brief report about our findings. And so they're gaining some objectivity or some objective results about their child's performance that's valuable in their child's treatment. So again, it's kind of a give and take where all of those things benefit someone who has a child with hearing loss, and that promotes retention in the study.